force Stony Brook to throw it underneath. Hopefully stop the ball in play and chew up some clock.
34 seconds remaining. Carbone bouncing to the outside. Draws it for Wheatley. Incomplete. 26 seconds remaining. It's 3rd and 10.
This was, for all intents and purposes, a Hail Mary. Carbone, running for his life, throws it into the end zone. Wingate does a great job, like a basketball player, making himself big, keeping the defender on his back, boxing out, comes up with the football. Absolutely incredible.
Rolling on the field is a touchdown. After the play, much more of like conduct against the offense, number 88. He removed his helmet. That 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
On 4th and 10, a 41-yard touchdown, and Chuck Priori's team is 17 seconds away from cementing its ticket to the postseason.
Take a look. Hail Mary, right? Watch the receiver get in front of the defender, boxes out like a power forward on the basketball team, comes down with the football, and incredibly, looks like Stony Brook is going to win this game.
A two-pointer to make it a three-point lead. Leontine driving and doesn't look like he got them. No good, so the two-pointer fails. 17 seconds remaining. This will be a kickoff from back the 20. Maybe Albany can get lucky back to the touchdown.
Watch, Carbone steps up in the pocket, just heaves it, and a la Aaron Rodgers, there's a miracle in Albany. Take a look, great angle by our cameraman. Look. Now, a little push up there by the receiver. No call by the official. He's able to get in front of the defender. Come down with the football.
Dutch Tyler Carswell out of the way. But he did a good job. Didn't extend those arms. Just kind of moved them. And big game. What a turn of events for Stony Brook.
I would expect to see a squib kick here. Donovan McDonald is a very dangerous return guy. I don't think he's going to get the chance. With only a few ticks left on the clock, it's going to take two miracles.
Two timeouts remaining for Albany. If you squib it, if you're the Great Danes, if you can attack the ball and grab it as fast as possible, maybe be a throw or two away from potentially field goal range.
Yeah, exactly. You swim and get the ball around midfield. You take a couple shots in the end zone. Wouldn't that be something back-to-back Hail Marys?
You know, Ethan Stark's hoping for a shot of redemption for Albany. McDonald and Beaufort back hoping for a chance. They do squib it at the 40. And great field position here for Albany. All the way to the 42 goes Missler. That's exactly what you had to worry about. And now, remember, on a tough day for Stark, he He has a 51-yarder this year. You're only 9 yards from that.
You're right. They don't need a touchdown. A field goal wins this football game. So you can take a shot or two. Albany still has two timeouts remaining. And they're only about, what would you say, about 10 yards from field goal range? Incredible.
If they get to the 35, they've tried. That's one completion. Four-man rush. Under Cutler, over the middle, Mole four. And they're in field goal range at the 31. Timeout with 4 seconds remaining.
Second, charge timeout.
Well, they're going to send the field goal unit out.
30
there's
seconds.
No question that
timeout.
Ethan Stark is going to get a chance to redeem himself. And wouldn't this be justice? The best kicker in the CAA who's had a difficult night has a chance to win the game for Albany.
Ofer, good job, just get as much as he could and give Stark a chance. He's a kid all year. He had missed 2 kicks, 1 field goal, 1 extra point. Today, he's missed 3.
Now the wind is blowing from his left to right and is swirling.
From 49 for the win.
Take a shot right there. Look at the jubilation. This game had more twists and turns than a movie script. And in a rivalry game, Albany hoisting the Golden Apple Trophy shocked Stony Brook. Just an incredible finish to a really entertaining football game.